Hi, everybody. I'm Jill Hendrickson, and I want to tell you about 4 days that I just spent with Brian Ridgway on the island of Hawaii. Now, the reason you might want to hear about this is perhaps your journey has been a little bit like mine. 30 years ago, I had an incredible taste of enlightenment. It came totally out of the blue. I was in a sacred park in Tokyo. And it was the most amazing experience of my life. And ever since then, my driving passion, the only thing that I really, really, really wanted was to have that experience again and to make it permanent. I was studying with an Indian master. I've been to India many times. I've stayed at ashrams. I've studied with just about every expert and spiritual teacher that whose name that you can come up with, either gone through their program or read their books, or both. And I didn't know that this journey was gonna take so long. Literally after 30 years, I was starting to lose hope. I was starting to get discouraged. I felt exhausted by the whole thing. And my greatest fear was that I was going to die without having what had been promised to me fulfilled, that I wasn't gonna have that experience. I never added up how much I invested in this journey of mine. I know it's well over 6 figures. And maybe you've been through something like that too, where you finally get to the point where you think, that's it, I'm done, no more, it's not leading anywhere. I am not doing another program, I'm not studying with another teacher, that's it. That's how I felt, and then came Brian. And there was just something about him that made me know this person has something that I need. The things that he spoke about showed me that he knew the kind of thing that I was looking for, and he actually had answers to some of the questions that I had that had never been answered by anybody. And so I had this gut feeling, this intuition that I really had to study with him, come what may. I didn't know how I was going to do it, but I just made the decision that I was going to. And before I got on that plane to go to Hawaii, Brian said to me that this was going to be the best experience of my life. And I thought that was kind of a bold statement, that he was pretty confident about that. And I wasn't so sure that it would be the best experience of my life. I was happy that he said so because it meant that he was going to do his best to make it the best experience. But in a life of many really amazing experiences, including the one I told you about 30 years ago, I really didn't think it was possible that he could top that. Well, I'm here to tell you, when I went to Hawaii and I was there for 4 days with Brian Ridgway, I had the best experience of my life. It was actually totally unexpected. It wasn't even the specific thing that I went there for, because I think I was afraid to even ask for what I really wanted because I didn't think it would happen and I didn't want to be disappointed anymore. But yeah, I really did have the best experience of my life, to the point where I found myself going to my room, throwing myself on the bed and just sobbing my heart out. And it wasn't out of any kind of sadness at all. It was out of relief and just this profound gratitude. Gratitude to my original teacher, gratitude to Brian, and gratitude to myself for sticking it out, for never giving up, and for having the courage to get on that plane and go to Hawaii to study with him. Now, if that had been the only thing that happened, that alone would have been enough. I really felt at that point that I could just die and I would die happy. That was it. I got what I wanted. But I see that there's so much more ahead too. There's more delight around the corner. And I do want people to know that this experience is available to them. Another thing that came out of this was that I realized that I really do have what it takes to teach what I want. Before this, I think that there was a part of me that felt a little bit hesitant because I didn't have that final piece. I didn't have that final validation. I got that during the 4 days when I was in Hawaii with Brian. And I have total conviction that I am totally qualified to teach what I want. I'm actually the authority on it, and I can help a lot of people. Being at Brian's house was amazing. I feel like he and his partner are friends of mine now. It's not just like I was a student going there and I was talked down to or taught. We had many interesting conversations. I learned a lot from them. One of the things that was really important was they're very into nutrition, and not in a boring way, but in a way that really supports you having the experience that you want. So that was incredible. And I've always been interested in nutrition and have wanted to eat right for myself and to support myself. But I learned things there that are going to be really helpful in the future, because having the right nutrition is going to let you have a much better ride in life. Well, they've got this amazing temple at their house. It's got a pyramid that you can sit in. There are just all these wild and crazy things that Brian actually uses on you. And normally that wouldn't be something that I was so interested in. But after experiencing those things, oh wow. I don't even totally understand how they work, but the important thing is that he does. And I'm sure that those things contributed to me having the amazing experience that I did. Now, I understand that Brian will travel to where you are to work with you, but I would say go to Hawaii. After all, it's a sacred island. The environment is so important when it comes to having an experience like this. I think it's really important to get away from your normal circumstances, away from all the reminders and the habits and the people, and just be someplace totally away from it all, where you can be totally devoted to your own experience. Interestingly, I spent most of the time that I was there flat on my back. And it's not because I'm a lazy person. It's because it's so important to take that deep dive to be totally relaxed and to calm yourself down. And it's not as though I was just laying there doing nothing. There were things that Brian had me doing while I was laying there flat on my back, but it was totally relaxing. And that too contributed to the possibility of me having that experience that I wanted. One of the things that is also going to be really great is that now I feel like I am done with programs. I am also done with a lot of books that I don't need anymore. So I can go into my vast library of materials that I've collected over the past 30 years and get rid of them. I don't need them anymore. Some of them might not even be true or valuable anyway. So it's opening up space in my life in many different ways, some of which I never even imagined. Well, if you're like me and you've spent an enormous amount of time and a fortune in the area of personal development and or spirituality, and you're just not getting what you need, if you have some big issue in your life that you just aren't able to tackle on your own, that's blocking you from having the incredible experience of life that you could have, definitely look into working with Brian. He's an amazing man. I've never met anybody like him. And by the way, I've traveled the world. I used to be a journalist. I've met a lot of pretty important people. He is in the top of amazing people that I've met. He has something for you. If you feel the pull to go study with him, don't deny yourself that, because you might have the best experience of your life also. And I feel so blessed, and I'm so grateful that I had the time to be with him one-on-one. He may not be available in the future. if this really gets out and people know what he has, it might not be possible to work with him one-on-one. So do it now when you have the chance. You will not regret it.